We're gonna get this juice is a derogatory term. It's not Judah. It's not the tribe of Judah. So the Jews and the priests sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask, "Who art thou?" They deputed, sent out of, to ask, which is the word areteal, eroteal. He confessed and denied not, but confessed, "I am not the Christ." John the Baptist said that, but denied not, which is the word arnimei, "I am not the Messiah." And they asked him, "What then? Art thou Elias?" Which is Elijah, referring to Malachi 4:5. "What then are we to say?" is "what then?" "What then?" was actually "what are we to say?" "Art thou Elijah?" And he said, "I am not." "Art thou that prophet?" And he answered, "No." That prophet is referring to Deuteronomy 18:18. And there was the Greek word And then they said unto him, verse 22, "Who art thou, that we may give an answer to them that sent us? What sayest thou of thyself?" And the word "sent" here is pempo. We'll get our word pemp. Characteristic word of this gospel. He said, "I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness, make straight the way of Yahweh," as said the prophet Isaiah. And he is quoting from Isaiah 43. Isaiah. This is the first of four occurrences of quotes and mentions of Isaiah and John, which confirms that Isaiah, as some say, the latter part of Isaiah was not written by the prophet Isaiah, but somebody else, but actually it's quoted by John, so in that day they didn't think that, so those are modern critics that try to twist the word, and it's not true. Isaiah was all written by Isaiah. And the voice of one crying in the waters, "Make straight the way of the Lord of Yeshua." And they which were sent were of the Pharisees. Had been sent of the Pharisees. And they asked him and said unto him, "Why baptize thou then, that thou be not that Christ, nor Elijah, neither that prophet Isaiah?" And baptism reason I asked about that is baptism was known from Ezekiel 36:25, where they expected baptism to happen because in Ezekiel 36:25 it says, "Then will I sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean from all your filthiness, and from all your idols will I cleanse you." So they were expecting this of Messiah. This is a fulfillment of his prophecy. When Israel shall be brought back into their own. Sprinkle was throw water upon you. Back to John. Baptize. And John answered them saying, verse 26, "I baptize with water, but there standeth one among you whom ye know not. He it is who," verse 27, "he it is who coming after me is before me, whose shoe latchet I am not worthy to unloose." 27. "Whose shoe latchet thong of a sandal so he was not worthy." He knew he was not worthy. These things were done in Bar-Thabara, beyond Jordan, where John was baptizing. Bar-Thabara is also known as Bethania, which often in Hebrew times they had many words for many names, multiple names for places, different expressions for them. Now it is near Jericho. It is now known as Makut Abarara. Makut Abarara. Abarara. Okay, I guess I'll stop it here again before it stops itself. So we got a little bit farther into John today, so we'll start moving along a little bit faster with these teachings from the Word, and looking into the Hebrew and the Greek, and considering any revelations about our flat, full earth that was created, our firmament, and our earth being not a ball floating in nothingness, but a created, purposefully created center of the universe for Yahweh's people. Yahweh bless you, and stay in the Lord, because every day in the Lord is a good day.